Welcome back to the Budget Gamer channel, where we bring you critical and in-depth reviews of just about every indie game we can get our hands on. And today we're going to be taking a look at The Great, perhaps, for the Nintendo Switch. And you may be wanting to ask me, was it great? And my answer would have to be, perhaps. But starting off with the story, as we always do, in The Great, perhaps, the story is actually, it's one of the more unique ones that I've seen in a long time. As an astronaut, or rather as a cosmonaut, you're waking up on the space station 100 years after you've gone into cryogenic sleep to be greeted with the destruction of your home world. Something happened, and apparently the details of what are neither here nor there, because the whole premise of the game involves you taking your AI along for a ride to go down to the surface of this post-apocalyptic world to see if there's anything, if at all, you could possibly do. And having done a scan for sentient life, you find that there is one life form in a 1,000 kilometer radius, and so you make it your mission to go take a hike and see if they're down for some company. Quickly though, and pretty much right after you get control of your character, you come across a mythical or mystical or possibly magical little lantern that allows you to phase shift in and out of the present and the past. Though how far back you go into the past isn't always well known, and neither is how this device actually seems to work. But as far as gameplay is concerned, your little lantern works pretty much the way you'd expect any magical lantern to work. Whether walking through the present or the past, should you activate your lantern, it'll cast a small circular beam of the opposite phase, letting you have a peek of what's going on behind the scenes. However, should you press and hold the button to activate your lantern, it'll send you into the other reality where you can actually interact with items and people. But you'll need to be really aware of dangers either in the past or in the present, and the fact that you can only stay in the past for up to about 20 seconds at a time. The present world is full of dangers, perilous collapsed buildings, as well as giant gaping chasms in the floor, and even some radioactive swamps. So you really don't want to rematerialize over some sort of hazard, because that will spell out instant death. The perils don't only limit themselves to the post-apocalyptic present, though, as being in the past, there are people who may not exactly have your best interest in mind. Thankfully, though, whether you get rolled up by the popo or fall into a pit of toxic ooze, dying in the game really doesn't have that much of a penalty. I don't exactly know how to indicate all of the checkpoints, but if you finish any piece of one of the game's puzzles, it's likely that dying is going to restart you pretty close to it. Moving away from the game's pretty intricate phase-shifting dynamics, overall, The Great perhaps really does play out like a very mild point-and-click adventure, or possibly a little bit closer to a walking sim. You will be navigating through a fairly linear progression of scenes, trying to find item A to open lock B. And while mostly that will just require you to phase into the present to walk through a smashed door, or maybe phase into the past to navigate around a giant pile of rubble, there are a few minigame-style puzzles thrown in the mix. But most of the adventure is definitely going to focus on the actual environmental puzzles, being able to just navigate around obstacles. Looking toward the game's graphics, though, visually it has a pretty good presentation. Though arguably the animations aren't exactly great, the scenery and the scenarios are pretty nice. And while the soundtrack of the game is also fairly decent, the voice acting is a little bit less than professional. But in all honesty, looking at the game, especially in consideration of its price, any faults in the audio or the visuals are pretty easily forgiven. But moving away from the general mechanics and its presentation, there are some critiques to talk about, or at least some things you might want to know about before diving into The Great, perhaps. And the first one to consider is definitely the game's genre itself. There are one or two times where you might actually have to jump in the game, but this is by no means a puzzle platformer. And though there are a couple of mini-game-style puzzle elements thrown in, it's hard to even call it a puzzle game. And that's why in the beginning of the review I referenced it actually as more closely akin to a walking sim. The goal of playing the game is merely to navigate through a scene to get the next little crumb of the story as it slowly unfolds. And so in that sense, the gameplay isn't really designed to be too terribly difficult, because the developers want people to experience the uniqueness of the story. But that does actually bring us to the next critique of just kind of a little bit of a WTF moment. For a game that's designed for gamers to have a fairly simplistic and fairly straightforward gameplay so that they can experience the story and suffer and struggle and get victories along with the main character, it doesn't really make a lot of sense that dying in the game is so ridiculously easy. Especially considering that most of the puzzling or obstacle situations are straightforward to the point that once you figure it out, there is really no replayability for it. Therefore, dying and having to do anything over again, no matter how minor, does quickly build up to be a bit of frustration. Other than that, though, looking back at the grade perhaps as a whole, the only other consideration would probably be for the game's length. It has a pretty good visual and audio presentation, if you can forgive the voice acting, and the story unfolds into some pretty unique situations. But don't go into it expecting a great catharsis at the end of your probably 2 hours of gameplay, because while you might get a little bit of closure for the main character's story, there's gonna be a lot of stuff that you kinda, maybe depending on what you were investing in, really wanted some answers for. But again, considering the game as a whole, especially in light of its price, if you are interested in experiencing a new story, or you just kinda want a new game to fool around with for a couple hours, if you are a puzzle gamer, if you're a fan of story games, if you're already a fan of walking sims, then The Grade perhaps might be one to put on your list. It's not long, it's not perfect, but it's also not expensive. And just for that uniqueness of the whole time phasing dimensional dynamic thing, it probably is worth a playthrough if you can get it while it's on sale. But anyway, that does about wrap up the review of The Grade perhaps now on the Nintendo Switch. So if you enjoyed the review, or especially if you found it helpful, feel free to throw me a comment or a like to show your support. And don't forget to click that little bell icon when you subscribe to stay updated with the latest content. There are thousands of indie games out there, and new and unique ones are coming out every single day. So chances are, if it's on the eShop, whether it's an easy hard pass or an absolutely unforgettable gem, you're probably gonna find out about it right here. But anyway, this has been The Budget Gamer, so as always, thanks for watching.